friend, I said, to consumer, this pollen, there are three criteria that you must look into. First is the source. Where do they get the pollen from? Are they, you know, is this a wild pollen or is a farm pollen? Big difference. Okay. The disadvantage of the farm pollen is, you know, recently there are a lot of bees dying. You know, this morning when I got up from my room, I saw two bees. Dead bees there, you know. That means either pollution, radiation from the handphone, or virus, infection, disease by the bees. They are like us also, right? The only difference is they don't consume lingzi, we consume lingzi. So they die easily. So what this, you know, the farmers, they tend to what? Spray antibiotic to make the bee stronger. Now, this is not a problem. The problem comes where the bee collected the pollen and then the farmers collected the pollen from the bees and the pollen contains a little bit of antibiotic. Ah, this is the danger. Because why? Every day you are swallowing antibiotic. So when you fall sick, you go to doctor prescribes you antibiotic, it is no longer effective because every day you have been consuming antibiotic. Ah, this is the disadvantage of farmed bee pollen. Second, I just educate them. Whenever you select a product of bee pollen, select the one with GMP. Good manufacturing practice. Does the factory have this, you know, certification? If not, don't consume. I educate them. The third is the technology to process this bee pollen. There are more than 100 companies that sell bee pollen in Japan, but only three companies passed the test of the government, and one of them is Songho. Why? Because if you do not so-called apply the good technology then to, you know, process this pollen, then your pollen is no longer as effective as what it is. Because pollen is something natural. And if you use a heat process, you are damaging the nutrient inside. Our pollen is different. Ours is using a freeze-dry technology, which will, you know, get rid of all the allergens, at the same time preserving the quality of the pollen. Whenever you educate your prospect or downline like that, they remember. Okay, they remember. So the next time they will buy pollen, they will start to, what, is this GMP? Is this freeze-dry technology? We are just educating them, you know. Don't lie to them, but tell them the solid fact. Okay, the second product is